My name is Shanna. I am a third year medical student at UBC. And so today's vlog is just what a typical weekend looks like. So you, even if you're in medical school medicine, become a doctor, I think it's always really important to work on your work-life balance. And so that's something I've been working on because I think I can really go to the all out on studying, etc. But now I'm just really working on trying to find a balance to keep fit, etc. So yeah, I do that. And then I do study, work on research, call again, and that's how a weekend just kind of gets occupied. So hello, today was a great day because my preceptor complimented me on building great rapport from a patient and able to get some really spicy history on their delusions, and so I feel really good. It's off my plate and now we gotta study some internal medicine
for tomorrow's exam.
So we wrote an exam this morning for internal medicine and psychiatry. I'm starting emergency medicine on Monday. Headaches, I'm gonna get through altered level of consciousness and probably abdominal. Pages, 9 pages, 10 pages. Alright, let's do this. Hey Daphne, look here. Gonna finish my workout with this Super Junior House Party Zumba choreo. And then I'm creating a presentation. And then I'm gonna screenshot all of these and then put them into iMovie so that I can record a voiceover narration video to submit for the competition. Now this, I was started watching Navarella. There's like this new K-drama. Really, a 70-year-old man who's been retired now loses two of his like best friends, and there's a lot of like talk about mortality with him and his buddies, and the regret that one of his best friends had before he dies is he regrets he never really got to carry out his dream. Your dream. He's like, well, you're still healthy, and you're still alive, and you still are able to go pursue your dreams, whatever you've always wanted to do with your life. Live it, to make sure you've lived it to the fullest and not hold yourself back. And so our main character has always wanted to learn ballet, but he grew up in a time where it's not acceptable for or at least in his family it wasn't acceptable for men to pursue ballet, and he also had to make ends meet and had to work like jobs that had a steady income and were maybe more predictable and safe. And so now he's sitting there and he's thinking like he really wants to pursue it. And so he does. He actually like is super brave and super inspiring that he's just gonna go for it. And that's how it's going right now. And so I thought it was just like interesting really to see the themes. And then to contrast that, the other main character is a young guy who is actually trained to be in a ballet, but he's not very motivated and he's kind of a bit of a slump when it comes to motivation, and kind of really, you know, it seems like he can't really remember why he's doing this in the first place and just having a rough time. So then they kind of work together, and that's how we're going. It's based on a webtoon. I'm also a big fan of reading webtoons. My boyfriend's gonna pick me up at 6:30. We're gonna go see the Van Gogh show. It's like a digital art display. I'm pretty excited. So the other day we decided to like read all about it. I'll read into the history of Van Gogh's life, and I also thought that was pretty inspiring. I know everyone knows Van Gogh as, you know, he had a pretty, what it sounds like to me, it sounds like he might have had bipolar disorder. He had also had an alcohol use disorder. Looks like he went to psychosis at some point or multiple times, but he was a gifted artist, no doubt. And what I didn't realize from learning, I think we were watching the videos from like the British National Gallery, and there's some different talks analyzing his art, is that his art is very unique. Before, you know, we know him for his color, but actually it was quite unusual at the time to use so many colors and paints, and the way he painted, the style that he painted with, was quite unique actually, because paint at the time was really expensive. So he was kind of very innovative, but he was also very dedicated to his art. So he was very disciplined. He wasn't just like, I'll hit canvas, but he forced himself to create art every single day. And he talked about how his dream is to create like beauty in this world basically, and he wanted to discipline himself so that he could work on becoming someone able to create beauty in the world. And I thought that was incredibly amazing. And I didn't know that actually some of his most famous works, some of what we're gonna see tonight, is, you know, for example, Starry Night, that was actually created while he was in an asylum, so a mental health institution, that and that was the view. Well, that was kind of a imagined view, and there's like pretty interesting if you like here, but like here that's some of the analysis about the symbolism. And anyways, that's just like something we wanted to do is just like read into people's like history and learn a little bit more about it so that we can engage with the art a bit more deeply. So anyways, I gotta stop talking. I really gotta film this. While you're thinking. But here, look at the cherry blossoms. So pretty.
It's right this time. And we're heading to Van Gogh. Not Go.
I'm saying Van Gogh forever.
Yeah.
You know, like the artist. And then it's actually Van Gogh, according to the British National Museum. What's the highlight of today's class?
It's the banh mi.
Are you still hungry?
Yes, always.
I think it was really nice to finish the exam yesterday. Like, I think my temptation was to spend today studying more and be like, oh no, you can't hike. Then I think about like how many weeks, you know, just thinking about the future, like how many weekends that I have to work, and then also like what is one day of studying.
So tired after that hike this morning, but I really want to make it my goal to finish watching all the merge videos before I start on Monday, because I'm on call tomorrow. So I figured to give myself some energy, I got to drink banana milk. You guys have had this. This is the one that's like honeydew flavor. Last psych call shift ever this morning. Today's Sunday. Bittersweet, because psych was quite fun. It was really nice, but just like practicing interviewing patients and asking them sorts of questions and things that I'm no longer afraid of. I think I still have ways to go. Like, for example, like just, you know, working on dictations and working on how to, you know, write notes, both like very inclusive yet, you know, not over inclusive. It's like this running balance. And it's now like 4:30 p.m. so I think it's time to just study a bit more. Tomorrow we have a progress test, just because we're now 75% of the way through clerkship, and just to check how much we've learned throughout the year.
Successful people say no to almost everything. Think about the time that you would have freed up.
Yeah,
Thank you so much for watching today's vlog. If you liked it, please subscribe and like it. Let me know what you like to watch. I don't really know if it's, I'd love to know if it's more interesting to watch like study vlogs for motivation, or I don't know, or you like, you miss the interviews, or you miss the sit down advice videos. I don't know, just let me know. Bye.